Okay, hello and welcome to the weather update for, make sure this is going, okay. Hello and welcome to the weather update for the 18th of February. We had some more snow today. Not a lot of snow, like 3 to 5 inches generally across the island. But the big problem is now things are very icy because we had a little period of freezing rain late this afternoon to the early evening. Even though it showed up on radar as snow, it was freezing rain. And this is what some of the roads look like in Hicksville. A lot of the Hicksville, you'll see I took a video. No snow removal at all on the streets whatsoever. Town of Oyster Bay, completely forgot about Hicksville. And this is what the streets look like here in Hicksville. Just a sheet of ice and very, very dangerous. Fortunately, in Mineola, it does not look like that. But this is what we got right now. So we're in a little bit of a break right now. This was the heavier thump of snow that came around noon. That was gone. And then we had this little bit of freezing rain in the late afternoon, early evening. That's gone. So right now it's just overcast. Looking at the skies, you'll see here, just got a lot of clouds around basically. And if we go to the CONUS view, you'll see what's going on here. We have this stall front that is over us right now, and you can see here's the front right here, right off to the south. And there'll be another impulse moving along it tomorrow that'll bring a little more wintry precipitation. So let's get the latest snow reports as of 4 p.m. from the National Weather Service here. And there is generally a... we're going to go over generally 3 to 5 inches generally is the general. I mean, nothing really. It's not a lot of snow. Elmont is the highest amount in Nassau at 5.8. Roseville had 5.5. Hempstead had 5.2. Seaford had 5.1. Massapequa, 4.3 inches. East Williston, 4.2 inches. New Hyde Park, 4.1 inches. Carl Place, 3.9 inches. So Central Park, 3.2 inches. Generally, you know, not a lot of snow. Some areas just a little more than others. There aren't huge variations. Deer Park was reporting 6 inches. West Islip was reporting 5 inches. Center Reach, 4 inches. Lindenhurst, 4 inches. Islip Airport, 3.7 inches. Upton, 2.4 inches. Generally, that's what we have now. There is another map that actually is better. And, you know, we can. This is actually a better map of the snowfall. It's actually a map of the snowfall reports that we have. So this really helps a lot to show you where these heavier bands actually set up. And there was a real heavy area of snow that we really didn't get into that wound up hitting Monmouth County and part of Middlesex County in New Jersey, stretching from Trenton. So through this section of New Jersey right here. And they got, in this band here, they've got reports 7 to 8 inches. Freehold actually reporting 9.7 inches. So, this whole part of New Jersey wound up getting hit. Wherever that heavy band of snow went right over that area right there and dropped a lot more, double the amount that everybody else did. And you go further south, you'll see, you know, you got the 2.1 in Whiting, the 3 in Toms River. Downtown Toms River has 2 inches. So, not a lot of snow over there. Same thing for the city, generally 3 to 2 inch reports. Here's Long Island. And again, you see 5.2, 4.8. Not really a huge variation. South Shore, 4.7. So there's not really a huge variation. Everybody got around that 3, 4, 5 inch. There's one 6.8. This might be a little suspect, East Northport. But other than that, everybody's pretty much around that 3, 4, 5 inch range that I was expecting. But what I was not expecting was that freezing rain to move in. And now we got to deal with the ice. Which is what is the problem right now? We're still below freezing, looking at the temperatures, and we still have a winter weather advisory in effect till 7 p.m. tomorrow because of the ice, and also because of the fact we're going to have a little more snow tomorrow, a little bit more. So you can see temperatures in the upper 20s; it's below freezing, so that's why we got the ice on the roads. But you'll see here as you go south into Toms River down the Jersey Shore, they're a little closer to freezing. So maybe we'll get into some of that warm air as we get toward the morning. One can only hope because the ice is really bad out there. Let's look at the accidents here because there are a number of accidents. Let's see how many accidents there are. Actually, I don't see too many here. Incident closures. I don't see anything here listed on here, but that doesn't mean that there isn't anything. Hopefully people are now going home. Once we started seeing the ice come, then we know we'd have a problem. Now, we know the way the streets are in Hicksville. I'm just curious. Now, this is probably just going to show us what it looks like on Sunrise Highway. We're not going to actually be able to see the side streets in Massapequa, but I bet they're plowed. I bet they are nice and plowed, and they're not full of snow because it's Massapequa. That's what it looks like there. But these only show the main roads. So I'm curious. I bet the residential streets in the southern part of the South Shore don't look like that. I bet you they look a lot nicer. So I just bet. Because I was pretty bad. I was pretty bad in Hicksville. Again, this is what it looks like in Hicksville. No plows came through at all in Hicksville. If you live on any of the residential streets in Hicksville, no plows came through. From what I heard, the same thing happened in Brookhaven Town, too. If we go to News 12, you'll see that they do report on this here. Brookhaven residents again decry speed of town snow removal efforts. So they were there. Their coverage of the storm was okay, but they spent a lot of time on the South Shore again. Not surprisingly, when you go look at where they were, if we go to their page, you'll see they were in Patchogue. They were in, if you've been watching, I was watching this all there in Patchogue. They were in Long Beach, all on the South Shore. See, West Islip. It's always on the South Shore with them, you know, because that's who they gear to, you know. Hey, look at the old footage they're using from Nice Bus. Oh, man, I miss the Orion Fives, man. They actually did better in the snow, man. Do you have to remind me how much I miss those buses? Come on. But anyway, going to News 12 here, you'll see they were on. This is what really gets me. Moderate snow. Look where they show. This is where they were in Long Beach. That's where they were, Long Beach. Here you go. I'll put the sound on.
Joins us from Long Beach, where several drivers, including a mail truck,
Long Beach.
Got stuck earlier today.
On the South Shore. So, again, it's the same.
Falling here in Long Beach. We seem to be in a little lull of.
Why is it always the South Shore with them? You know? I mean. Let's see. Let's see. There was another report there in Patchogue. Let's see if this is it.
Kevin Vesey continues our team coverage in Suffolk, where police have responded to several crashes.
He's in Patchogue. See? Kevin. Look at this.
Yeah, that's right, Rich. You know, the snow has stopped falling for now here in Patchogue, but the cleanup is.
Yeah, see, look, they're in Patchogue, and look at how nice that sidewalk looks, too. That road could be a little better. I'll admit. But, you know, just again, just shows you it's all about the South Shore. And then look at this. Businesses take a hit during snowstorm on the South Shore. You got to be kidding me. What about the businesses here? Again, where are they this time?
Snow is coming down hard and fast and really mixing with.
Where is he?
We're in Sayville right
Sayville.
Now. Sayville! See that the snow is coming down hard and fast and really.
Why don't they ever go to the middle of the island?
It's
all about a certain demographic there. What can I tell you? That's what it is. So that's why you'll definitely want to watch my video and my coverage of what things were in the middle of the island, because News 12 obviously could care less about it. All right. We looked at the. Let's look at the MTA now and see what effects are. The railroad had some switch trouble earlier in New Hyde Park that resulted in minor delays. There was also a broken rail near Nostrand Avenue that was repaired. But otherwise, the railroad didn't really have anything catastrophic going on. The subways, unfortunately, do. And this Queens Boulevard line is completely suspended. E, F, M, and R trains to and from Queens is suspended because of a power outage at Queensborough Plaza. Power failure at Queensborough Plaza and numerous malfunctioning signals near 46th Street. So this is a mess right now. Long Island Railroad is cross-armed between 34th Street, Penn Station, and Jamaica Center. So a big mess on the subways right now because of a power outage. I think this is only affecting the subways. I don't think. We can go to Con Edison power outage map and see if this even shows up on here. See if this is even affecting any customers as far as the customers in Queens. Oh, there are 60 plus here, I'm wondering. All right, so it's in the current Queensborough Plaza. Jovia. I don't see anything. Well, it may. It looks like it's just affecting the subways. I don't see any. Yeah, I don't see anyone actually out of power in the area around Queensboro Plaza. So I don't see any power. I think it's just affecting the subways. It's not affecting any customers. Okay, so let's get to the weather aspect of this thing, because next is that's where we got to go next. So let's go to Tropical Tidbits and start looking at what the models and seeing what's coming up next here with this, because this was our first storm, but there's going to be a second storm that we're going to be dealing with here. Let's go take a look and see we'll start with, I guess we're going to go to our local, go to East Coast, so you get an idea. We'll get a, just starting with the surface. So there's your first low moving out, but you see there's a second low. This is the GFS, you'll see. That's going to keep the precipitation around tomorrow, through much of tomorrow, actually. And it could be a light snow, light rain mix. Then that finally pulls out, and then we dry out for the weekend, all right? But this is going to bring more in the terms of precipitation to our area. So looking at the GFS, you see. But you see the GFS keeps us on the line, because temperature is going to be in the mid-30s tomorrow, which is going to keep us on the line. We'll go to the NAM 12. This is, again, the 18Z run here that we have. And, again, you will see we're kind of on the line here. We're dealing with a little light precipitation tonight, but then we get into some more moderate precipitation, lighter to moderate precipitation tomorrow. And that could bring us possibly another inch of snow. But you can see it just lingers around, and it doesn't really even move out of here until 7 or 8 p.m. after, you know, tomorrow night. So this stall front is really hard to push out, because you have two separate systems. Here's System 1. That's the one we dealt with today. And here comes System 2 for tomorrow. So, the stall front's really taking its sweet time moving away. So when you look at this, you're like, well, how much more snow are we going to get? Well, the NAM is saying just an inch or two, so it won't really be that much more than and it probably won't even accumulate on the roads. Probably not. Because I think the temperatures are going to be above freezing, and it's happening largely during the day. So I don't really predict that much more accumulation, and maybe an inch or so tomorrow. This is the NAM model, okay? So let's go move it over to the HRRR model. This is the next model, and this is all I've got of the 0Z. I've got 15 hours of it. But if we go all the way out to 15Z tomorrow, you'll see it's got us in the most minimal part of snowfall here. So like I said, I really don't see, this goes a little further out if I use this part here. You see we're just on the edge of this, and it's going to be very light tomorrow. It won't be as moderate as it was. It won't have any bursts of snow like we had today. It'll be very light, but until those temperatures get above freezing, we've got to worry about the ice. So we're going to look at the temperatures on this and see. And you see by tomorrow, then we are above freezing. But let's go back to now, all right? So we're below freezing. We're in the blue. You see that, all right? So as we move this along, as we go into the morning, you'll see slowly warmer air creeps in from the east end and then from the Jersey Shore. So it'll slowly creep into our area, but very, very slowly. So we're probably not going to get above freezing until probably after 9 a.m. tomorrow. And then we'll get above freezing, and then this ice should be a little less of a threat. But right now, we have to worry about getting more ice. And if we look at the total accumulated precip, this is what we could see. It's not going to be a whole lot more precipitation. You see here, this is the total equipment, the total liquid equivalent here, and it's only maybe a tenth of an inch at most. However, it doesn't take a lot if it's ice. And that's the concern that I've got for tonight. Let me go back to the NAM 12. This is the NAM 12, and you see the NAM 12 is actually a little heavier, not surprisingly. And we're going to push this all the way to zeros, and you can see east end could get a little more in the way of liquid equivalent. Hopefully this will happen when temperatures rise above freezing. For the rest of us, we're dealing with, again, that just a little bit more. But if it's ice, that's what the problem is. Now we can look at the temperatures on the NAM, which will no doubt probably be a little colder, but still looks like we're healthily above freezing So we go above freezing around that same time, 8, 9 o'clock. And once we do, we can lose some of that ice. However, once the storm pulls away, temperatures will start dropping once again. As we head into Saturday, you'll see here temperatures drop. The NAM seems to think we're going to make it above freezing on Saturday. So that's the good news. And this, we could start melting some of the snow. Although it wasn't a whole lot, it's annoying to have it once again around to deal with. You know. So once this is all gone, and we get rid of this storm, all right, temperatures will drop tomorrow night, drop probably into the 20s. And then for Saturday, you see the highs probably in the low 30s. See, the GFS actually is a little colder than the NAM, which is interesting. GFS has us around 30 degrees. So struggle to reach the freezing mark, I think, on Saturday, especially with the snow cover around. And it will be kind of breezy, too, as well. And then it's going to be cold Saturday night, lows in 15 to 20 degrees. And then for Sunday, similar deal with highs, struggling to reach the freezing mark. And then we should start a moderating trend after that. So when I go, we're going to pull out and we're going to look at the North American region. And we are going to look at the upper air and look at what comes next here as we look into the long range here a little more. Like I said, this is the trough. Bring us the cold air this weekend. It pulls out. Another trough moves through for the early part of the week. That'll be another storm right there that we'll have to keep an eye on. And then we get some ridging. So you see that zonal flow and a little ridging. So we go to normal to above normal. And then the next little lobe comes through. Brings us another cold front. And then here we go. You can see, though, there's another vortex of really cold air. And the question is, will we see that, or are we going to deal with this ridge in the east again kind of deal? And this is, like I said, once you go that far out, it's going to be hard to tell what's going to happen because the track record with the models has not been good. And so that's why I don't want to spend too much time on it, because that's just guessing at this point. It really is just, you know, there's a 50% chance it's going to be right and a 50% chance it won't. But one thing that we do know is that it will moderate as we head into next week. So there's our storms. Get rid of that storm. We get the high pressure building in, but look at the isobars being tight. That means northwest winds. Could be a little breezy at times on Saturday, making them feel pretty chilly. High moves directly over us on Sunday, so less wind. And then the next system comes through. GFS right now has this being rain. And not snow. Hopefully, I don't think it'll be that major. There's no coastal component, and it's just very progressive, moving from west to east. Another high builds in for the remainder of the week, and then we just have fair weather, and then we'd have to watch this next storm system, perhaps along a front, possibly for Thursday. That again looks fairly light. Then another high builds in, and then this low goes way up, and it takes that track way up into Canada, so that would just be rain to kick off the beginning of March. And we kick up the beginning of March with the lows going to the west and us getting rain and not snow, but the cold air behind the front. So when we go ahead and we look at our temperatures, and we will go ahead and look at our actual air temperatures, not anomalies, just to show you where the cold air is at in the nation, you will see that as we head into the weekend, you see get that little bit of cold air there. And then we start moderating. Here's Monday. You can see we're ready. You don't see the blue over us. It's Tuesday. You don't see the blue over us. And so we start warming up. And then for the weekend, next weekend, we get a little cold shot on Friday, and then it warms up again. So really not really any cold air, any bitter cold air, but you can see that it is up there in Canada, and it might try to make a move at us as we get into March. We'll have to keep an eye on that and see if we do get into that or not. So as we get a little closer and we look more into next week now, all right, so we go into Monday and you see temperatures basically around 40 degrees. Same thing for Tuesday. That's why I think that system will be rain. And then we're in the 40s. Look at that. Maybe even 50s in New Jersey for Wednesday. Back down to the 30s again. And Friday could be a cold day. Highs may be around 30. And then we warm up again for the weekend a little bit. And then the next cold front would come through after that. And I don't want to go any further than that. So, you know, I mean, we all know that we're not going to see any really bitter cold. But hopefully we can see the sun again. So, obviously, tomorrow we're not going to see the sun. But for Saturday, it looks like we should get, hopefully, a mostly sunny day out of it. This is the cloud, thing. If not Saturday, even Sunday looks even sunnier. So the weekend looks nice. We're going to have sunshine. And the good news is the train start will be running. So I can get to the Pine Barrens. But the clouds will be back in the picture for Monday. Tuesday, we'll be dealing with some clouds. And then, it'll be kind of a junky week next week. So enjoy the sunshine on the weekend. Probably have to wait till Friday before we can get rid of it. And it looks like Friday could be a nice clear day. And a cold day, too, again, with those highs only in the 20s. Saturday, next Saturday right now looks nice. Sunday, more clouds roll into the picture. And again, this is the long-range cloud forecast, which I don't really like going more than 5 days out with. All right, because I think it's highly inaccurate as you go more that far out. So let's look at the NAM sky cover forecast. And take a look and see. So you see those clouds kind of lingering, but we do get rid of them. This is the NAM, which seems to want to linger the clouds over Long Island and clear it out over New Jersey more. And then has more instability cloudiness in the afternoon. That's as far as you get on the NAM. I could also look at the RGM as well for the weekend. You can see we get rid of these clouds. Saturday, I think Saturday we'll see a decent amount of sun. There'll probably be a few clouds. Sunday probably will be the clearer of the 2 days. Sunday looks completely clear and very nice. And then the clouds start rolling in for that next system on Monday. So I think that's going to wrap up this weather update. Again, we got to worry about the ice tonight. That's the main thing because, again, this is what things look like out there right now. It's not good at all. What it looks like is another picture of what it looks like. It's really very slippery depending on where you are. If they didn't clear the roads at all. And News 12 should be talking about this. I think they did do a story on Brookhaven, but they need to talk about what's going on in Hicksville as well, because Hicksville's just been completely forgotten by the town of Oyster Bay once again. This is not acceptable at all to have the roads like this, but they just think, well, it'll just melt, and that's the way they think, you know. Some of the, like I said, the two worst townships on Long Island, Brookhaven and Oyster Bay, they always seem to have problems with this kind of stuff. When it comes to removing snow, and now this is all ice, and it's very slippery. So if anyone has to drive on these streets, they've got to take it really slow because, I mean, there's no sand, no salt. It's just a sheet of ice. So be careful out there, and hopefully by tomorrow we can get rid of this. This stuff can melt because this is very dangerous right here. Take care, and thank you for watching.